Inventory management in Excel. Inventory is there to shield us from the unknowns and to reduce risks, as you cannot rely on suppliers to have immediate on-hand stock of all the items that you need. Now the question is, how much inventory is enough? Where do we draw the line? Just as the inventory helps reduce risk, it is also coming at cost and its own risks. Okay. There is a chance it will get spoiled. You need to pay for storage, climate control, maybe a security guard as well. And in the end, you might not even use it for months or years to come. This is why many businesses are not considering inventory as an asset, but as a liability, since it is tying up working capital. In order to address this issue, many companies employed different inventory management techniques in order to balance out inventory to correct value. Balancing inventory is one of the toughest aspects of operations management. By successfully balancing inventory with actual demand, you will minimize risks of losing sales to competition or leaving you with unnecessary inventory. However, customer demand is very variable and forecast is always going to be inaccurate, so don't stress about it. Also, we employ different forecasting models. And if you did not see this lecture on how to forecast in Excel, I suggest that you pause this video and go and watch it. Okay. As we mentioned earlier, having too much inventory will cost you, and having too little will lead you to lost sales, risk of losing reputation, and bad customer service. Therefore, as an operations manager, you must balance out both. Inventory management, being one of the most difficult tasks in operations, can be approached in many different ways. Right one depends on your actual business environment. Point here is to create a system that delivers right materials at the right time. So let's see the Excel sheet that I prepared here for you. We have 7 tabs here. I will start from orange ones, as these are the ones where you should be editing something. Blue tab is for your information, and green one will give you information on how much excess stock you have or how much you need to order. The last one is the introduction tab. Okay, let's go. So I'll start by going through all the tabs. The first tab I'm going through is items list. The items list tab is the one that you need to populate. It's giving you, it has item numbers. Maybe it's called part number, part numbers in your company. Then a product description. In this case, I call them blue item, red item, purple item, and so on. Then unit price, how much one of these cost. Then who is your supplier? Company Z, X, Y. Where is this located? And this is it. Also, lead times. Lead time is time between the time you place the order to receiving the item. So we place those. This is per our past knowledge and experience, or if you ask your supplier how many days or months it takes to receive an item. Also, we have minimum order quantity. I placed once everywhere, but you know, You cannot buy 1 inch of wire. You probably have to buy a roll. You cannot buy, I don't know, one O-ring. You need to buy a pack, and so on. You need to measure piece, meter, pack, whatever. Depends on your company, your situation, your part numbers. So that's basically it. There are no formulas here, just plain text, and you need to populate this. This is the first step. Second thing is stock on hand. These are all the part numbers that we have. There are formulas tying up descriptions, so if you delete it, you get an error, but if you put the item number, you will get back description and unit price and everything else. Then quantity. This is something that your storekeeper has to count, and I suggest that counts are being done on a regular basis, maybe every month or 2 months. You need to know what's the status of your storage, correct one. Then line value. What's the value of these items that you are storing, and for your information, who's a supplier. I also placed here for your information what to see, what's the value of our current inventory in this virtual company. It's about $1 million. So next step, items on order. So what is this? So remember when we said lead time, it takes time to get some item. So you might have placed an order for this purple item or white item, but it takes maybe 2 months to get it. What if your forecast changes, you lose a job or something happens? Then you should come back and identify this line and contact your supplier. Maybe you can cancel the order and don't get hit in your P&L. Now, this is more or less manual. Everything that is orange is manual type in. So you put in the part number, reference number, to purchase. Maybe it's a purchase order. Depending on your company, you might call it differently. And the quantity that's in this purchase reference. And that's it. Let's move on to the next step. Now, this tab is giving you historic values. Historic values of your sales. And this is some data collection that you should be doing all the time. Your sales department probably knows how many items it sold, and even to what customer, and so on. So this is 12 months of sales data. And also you have average for those 12 months. There are no big formulas here. There's an item number and just a simple VLOOKUP to get description, and that's it. Now, the next one is a little bit more complicated. And you don't have to type in anything in this worksheet. What we have are all part numbers that we have in our storage. Then descriptions, they come with VLOOKUP. Then sales in the past from 12 months to 1 month, and then in the going to future. You see these are past data, and from here on we are going to future. And also we need a period. If you remember forecasting video tutorial, you need some timeline, some period. So this is it. And also, how many months are we forecasting to? This is 6 months. Let's correct this one. There we go. So forecast, we are using a seasonality formula. Everything is by default, and then we are also rounding it up. So let's see how it's looking without rounding up. So it's 15.15. Now you cannot order 15.15 of a blue item. Maybe it's a tire, you know. So you can order either 15 or you can order 16. In this case, I chose to round up to whatever is the closest one. You can also use a round up. So, and then you see it's going to be 16. But let's keep it simple. Let's just round up to the closest number. Like before, we have different arguments. We have values. Well, first one, the period we want to forecast to. Then we have values, and we have past date, the past timeline. And everything else goes by default. Now, keep in mind to lock period and to lock the period that you're interested to get forecast for. Because if you just scroll this over, it's gonna start showing some weird numbers. And that's it for forecast tab. It's giving you a forecast next 6 months of forecast. Now, going to the green tab, inventory management, this is where you get all this data combined into one sheet. So we see here forecasted data next 6 months. We see item number. We see quantity on hand, how much we have in our inventory. Quantity on order, how much are we having on order. Lead time, this is very important. If the lead time is huge, then you probably need to order more. Then minimum order quantity, all of this data is here. And now I used one a bit more complicated formula compared to VLOOKUP and SUMIF. I used SUMIFs here. And you have formula here. You can copy it, you can use it, reuse it any way you want. It is basing its forecast it's basing its value on how much we need to order based on the future data forecast, what we have, what we are gonna receive, also lead times and minimum order quantity. So let's say here that minimum order quantity suddenly becomes 15, and that's apparently okay. But let's put some huge number. Then you see that now it's matching. What if our lead time changes? What if our lead time is half a day? Then we don't need to order that much, right? We go down to 595 items. Also, one is the same because we are rounding it up. It's per month, so but if you put 5, suddenly it's a lot more. So this is also something you should be considering when you're evaluating these things. What else do we have? We have unit of measure. It's nice to know. What's the value of your order? It's 3.8 million, right? But if you had different values here, then it would be significantly less, right? Okay, so what's the rest of the things we have? Okay, so inventory extra. So now I try to identify how much maybe we can sell. You know, maybe you can sell back these items to your supplier. Maybe they will accept it, probably with discount, you know, but it's getting off your hand. You get you're getting money to buy what you actually need. Maybe you're working in a global company, and then you can send it to another part of the world and then use that inventory over there and actually make profit as a global company. That's why we are having these things. And in our case, we have 500,000 there. So what else do we have here? What else can we see? Well, you see, we can filter out what we have on order, right? With inventory extra. So now we have 987 on order, but we have 669 extra. What would you do now? Well, the easiest thing to do is to go to items ordered, go look for 236 white item, and check this purchase reference. Call the supplier and maybe you can cancel this order. It's the easiest thing to do. And I suggest you always do it. That's the if you're having difficulties in your company, this is the first thing you need to do. Check all the pending orders, everything that's coming in. Maybe you don't need some things. It's easy, and it might be very helpful. Okay, so that is summing up our Excel sheet and managing inventory in Excel. I hope you can use this information in your work, and good luck.